Hello dear students and welcome in our biology session. So we are discussing our organ system and the name of the organ system is what? Circulatory system. About circulatory system we have already seen in our previous video. In that we have discussed about what is meant by blood, which type of the components are formed in the blood, which are the different substances are formed in the blood. And today we will see the next point, that is what? Blood vessels. Okay, blood vessels means what? These are the tube like structure which helps to flow the blood in our body. Okay, so there are the three blood vessels which helps, or with the help of that blood vessels the blood is flowing or the circulated in our body. Okay, so let's see the first blood vessel we are going to see, that is nothing but what? Arteries. Okay, so the arteries are the blood vessels which carries blood from heart to different parts of the body. Okay, so arteries are the blood vessels, these are the tube like structure, okay, that we are calling as what? Blood vessels. Okay, so the arteries are the blood vessels which carries the blood from heart to the different parts of the body. Okay, and they carries the oxygen rich blood. Okay, so see, they are carrying the blood from the heart, so it means what? They are carrying the oxygen rich blood. Okay, so the arteries are the blood vessels which carry the blood from heart to the different organs of a body. And which type of the blood they carry? They carries the oxygen rich blood. Okay, but for this condition one exception is there. There is one artery and the name of that artery is what? Pulmonary artery. Okay, so this pulmonary artery doesn't carry the oxygen rich blood. Okay, why this is, that we are going to see in our upcoming session. Okay, but here now you have to keep in your mind that what? All the arteries can carry the blood from the heart to the different parts of the body. Which type of the blood? Oxygen rich blood. But only the pulmonary arteries doesn't carry the oxygen rich blood. Okay, next one is that the arteries have thick and elastic walls. Okay, the walls of the arteries are thick and elastic. Why it is so? Because as the blood is coming from the heart, okay, so in the arteries the blood is coming from the heart, and that is the reason the flow of the blood is very high. Okay, so the blood flow is rapid and at a high pressure. Okay, so in the arteries the blood flow is very rapid and the pressure is also high, and that is the reason that the arteries are having thick and elastic walls. Okay, so because of that pressure it can get increased somehow in the size, and that is the reason it is what? They are having the thick and elastic walls, because the blood flow in the arteries is how? Blood flow is rapid and at high pressure. Okay, now the next one is that lie quite deep under the skin. Okay, so these arteries are situated very deep in under our skin, so that is the reason we cannot see the arteries very easily. Okay, so these arteries lies quite very deep under the skin, so we cannot see them very clearly, or we cannot see them very easily. Okay, so this is the first type of the blood vessel, that is nothing but what? Arteries. Okay, we'll move for the next blood vessel, that is nothing but what? Veins. Okay, so let's see what is mean by veins. So these are the veins, or the veins are the blood vessels which carries the blood from all the parts of the body back to the heart. Okay, so see, keep in the mind, very important, what is mean by the vein? The veins are the blood vessels which carries the blood, okay, which carry the blood from all the body parts, which carry the blood from all the body parts to heart. Okay, see, all the body parts to back to the heart. Okay, so the veins carry the blood from all the body parts back to heart. So from the different organs of the body the impure blood again goes to the heart with the help of the veins. Okay, with the help of the veins. Okay, and which type of the blood carries by the vein? So the vein carry CO2 rich blood. Now CO2 rich blood means what? Carbon dioxide rich blood. Okay, so the veins can carry the carbon dioxide rich blood. for this condition also again there is one exception, that is nothing but what, except pulmonary vein. Okay, so all the veins carries the carbon dioxide rich blood from the different body parts to the heart, but only the pulmonary vein doesn't carry the carbon dioxide rich blood. Okay, next one is the walls of veins are thin and less elastic. Okay, so thin and the less elastic muscular wall. Okay, and the wall of the veins are thin and less elastic, they are not that much elastic as compared to the arteries. Okay, next one is that less deeply situated than arteries, they are not that much deeply situated under our skin, they are superficial to our skin. If you can see your hand under the skin, you can see the bluish or the greenish lines, okay, on your hands or on your legs. Okay, so that bluish greenish color lines, these are nothing but what, veins. Okay, so it means what, the veins are not situated very deeply under the skin, we can see them from our skin. Next one is that very important, that is they have valves. Okay, so the veins are having the valves. Why only the veins are having the valves? Because the veins are transporting the blood. Okay, so see, they have the valves which allow the blood to flow in one direction only, that is what, towards the heart. Okay, so see, we are means with the help of the veins the blood can get transported to the heart. It means what, the blood is going towards the opposite to the gravity. Okay, with the in the veins what happened, the blood is flowing opposite to the gravity, and that is the reason they are having the valves. Because of that valves, the once it goes up it never comes down. Okay, so the veins are having the valves which allow the direction of the blood only in the one direction, that is what, towards the heart. Okay, so this is all about what, veins. They carry the blood from all the parts of the body back to the heart, carry carbon dioxide rich blood. Also they are thin and less elastic, less deeply situated, and they are having the valves. Okay, now we'll move for the next blood vessel, that is nothing but what, capillaries. Okay, so the capillaries are extremely thin blood vessels which connect the arteries to veins. Okay, so the arteries and the veins are connected to each other with the help of the very fine blood vessel, and the name of that very fine blood vessel is nothing but what, capillaries. Okay, so the extremely thin blood vessel which connects the arteries to veins. Okay, so the capillaries are the very thin blood vessels which connects the arteries and veins. Okay, next one, the wall of the capillaries helps to exchange the useful material. Okay, see how they are, they are very thin. Okay, so the walls of the capillaries helps to exchange some useful material like what, food and the oxygen. Okay, so food on and the oxygen with the help of the capillaries get mixed into the blood, and then with the help of the blood it get transported to the different parts of the body. But at the same time some excretory products also get mixed into the blood, and with the help of the blood it goes into the capillaries. Okay, so for example we can say that we are doing the breathing process. While doing the breathing process, what we exhale out, that is what, carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide. So it is necessary to throw out that carbon dioxide. Okay, so how it get transported into the blood, with the help of these capillaries. Okay, so see the next point, also helps to transport the waste products like carbon dioxide formed in the body cells, enter the blood through the thin walls of the capillaries. Okay, so how we are throwing out the carbon dioxide which is produced into the cell, so with the help of the capillaries the carbon dioxide get mixed into the blood, and then we are throwing out it outside the body. Okay, so in short what we can say, that capillaries connects the arteries and the veins, also it helps to transport the useful material, and also it helps to transport the waste materials with the help of the capillaries. Okay, so this is all about different blood vessels. With the help of this blood vessel, the blood is getting circulated in our body. Different types of the material is getting transported to our body. Okay, so which are the blood vessels? Arteries, veins and capillaries. Okay, so this is all about today. This is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.